Meghan and Prince Harry's children Archie Harrison and Lilibet Lily Diana live with their parents in Montecito, Santa Barbara. On the other hand, Prince George, Princess Charlotte and Prince Louis are believed to be in London ahead of their return to school and nursery. This means Kate and Prince William could take their children to the sunken garden, on the grounds of Kensington Palace, today to visit the statue of Princess Diana. The Dukes of Cambridge and Sussex unveiled on July 1 and pay tribute to their late grandmother. The distance between London and Santa Barbara, as well as the travel restrictions still in place due to COVID-19 and the tender age of their children, makes it difficult for the Sussexes to be able to visit the statue of Diana on the 24th anniversary of the princess's death. However, the distance from the Kensington Palace is not barring Prince Harry and Meghan from bringing up their children in the knowledge of Princess Diana. In the fifth episode of the mental health series he co-created with Oprah Winfrey and released on Apple TV Plus before the birth of Lily, the Duke of Sussex revealed he has a picture of his beloved mother in the nursery. In the Me You Can't See, Harry also said, "I got a photo of her in his nursery, and it was one of the first words that he, Archie, said apart from Mama, Papa, it was then Grandma. Grandma Diana. It's the sweetest thing, but at the same time, it makes me really sad because she should be here." He added, "I wish she could have met Meghan. I wish she was around for Archie." Meghan and Harry also chose to honor Princess Diana by naming their daughter after her. Similarly, Prince William is known to often speak about his mother to his children. In 2017, the Duke said, as he appeared on the documentary Diana, Our Mother, Her Life and Legacy, he constantly talks to his children about Granny Diana at bedtime. This is because he wants them to grow up knowing there are two grandmothers in their lives. He also said, "We TMV got more photos up around the house now of her and we talk about her a bit." The Spanish royal family bid an emotional goodbye to King Felipe V and Queen Letizia's eldest daughter as she left Madrid for the UK. The face mask worn by the Spanish royals did not conceal their emotions as King Felipe, 53, Queen Letizia, 48, and Infanta Sofia, 14, waved off the heir to the throne, Princess Leonor. The 15-year-old has moved to the UK to attend for the next 2 years her international baccalaureate at the UWC Atlantic College in Llantwit Major, Wales. The teenager and future queen said goodbye to her family at Adolfo Suarez Barajos Airport in Madrid. The four Spanish royals wore casual outfits for the trip to the airport, where Leonor was photographed saying goodbye to her parents and sister goodbye. Leonor, who left Spain for Wales yesterday, was seen hugging tightly her sister and mother. She also embraced her father before exchanging what appeared to be a smile under their face coverings. See more pictures of the emotional goodbye here. Princess Diana's brother Charles, 9th Earl Spencer, appears to have marked the 24th anniversary of the death of the Princess of Wales with a heartbreaking tribute. Earl Spencer shared on his Twitter account a picture showing the Spencer banner flying half-mast at Althorp House. Princess Diana's brother did not add a caption to this picture, but it is highly likely this gesture is a tribute to his older sister, who died in a car crash on this day in 1997. The Queen should issue a final peace offering to Prince Harry and demand he attends her Platinum Jubilee celebrations next year, a royal commentator has claimed. Prince Harry, 36, and Meghan Markle's, 40, departure from the firm and relocation to California means it's not clear whether they will return to the UK to celebrate Queen Elizabeth II's Platinum Jubilee next year. Although Harry's relationship with the firm, namely Prince Charles, 72, and his brother Prince William, 39, are thought to be strained, royal commentator Marlene Koenig has claimed inviting the Duke to the celebrations next year would be the perfect olive branch. While Harry and Meghan have not returned as a pair since they left the country in March 2020, Ms. Koenig said they still remain important to the firm. Speaking to Express.co.uk, Ms. Koenig said, "I think it would just send a good message. Forget about the previous comments and statements that have been said. This would be the Queen saying, 'You are my family.' And I think that would be very important." Ms. Koenig added, I would think that it would be the perfect olive branch for the Queen to say, "I want you there." The Queen's great-nephew is reportedly set to start training with the Royal Marines. Arthur Chatto, 22, has told the Queen he will start his training to become an officer in the Royal Marines, The Sun has reported. Arthur is the son of Princess Margaret TM's daughter, Lady Sarah, the Queen's only niece. A royal insider told The Sun, Arthur Chatto has been accepted to train as an officer in the Royal Marines. He told the Queen all about it and she TM's pleased and proud. Prince Edward has been very supportive. Arthur has even been going off into the wilds at Balmoral with all his kit and camping out as he prepares for the commando training. The royal insider continued, he has gone straight into the officer training in this year TM's intake and is very keen and up for it. Kate, Duchess of Cambridge, has channeled Princess Diana's style numerous times, to the point she has been seen donning almost identical outfits to the one TM's Diana, Princess of Wales, once wore. But is the Duchess of Cambridge trying to emulate her style deliberately? Fashion designer Melita Latham told Express.co.uk that both styles differ completely and that while anyone can replicate Kate's ensemble, Princess Diana's presence is impossible to emulate. Ms. Latham said Diana certainly had her own style. She continued, from her first unexpected appearance in the limelight, she had a particular style that shone, almost as much as her beauty. The fashion expert explained, she could have arrived at any engagement in an old sack, and would have the attendees in awe. Wearing khaki trousers and a white blouse, and armor to protect her, while inspecting minefields, is a moment few will forget, but just as few would be able to make such an impression wearing similar. She also said, rarely does this beauty, charm, presence and style appear in one, as perfectly as it did with Diana. Kate, the expert went on, is everything a princess, and one day a queen ought to be, of this there can be no doubt. However, she added, our first truly beautiful princess, as princesses are supposed to be in fairy tales, was Diana. She was the Model T. Of course, 40 years later, Kate is no less of a princess, and in today's TM's fashion marketplace, anyone can replicate her ensemble.